Ryan King. Ryan King, that's what you want to talk about, right? Here's the thing about Ryan King, man. He don't know how to shut the fuck up. You know? Ryan King is the type of dude, like, he was a nerd. Like, Ryan King let his name get to his head. And that's his daddy fault. His daddy should have realized that he couldn't give that boy the name King, and he should have changed his motherfucking name. That motherfucker looked like he needed milk, and he ain't wrestling. I bet you he don't even listen. Man, listen, man. I'm going to tell you how it all got started between me and Mr. King. You know, I was sitting back one day. It was the match after I had your homeboy, Leroy. Shout out to Leroy. He could fight. He could do his thing, man. But I still bust that ass. But, you know, I give him props, man. But we're sitting back. I was sitting back with them boys, my homies, my folks. And we sitting back drinking beers, kicking back, counting this money that we just made off the damn SWF. We laughing and shit, watching the match, watching the replays. You know, we in a good mood. I just won. And I said, you know what? I need to set this heat up between me and somebody else. You know, I'm just watching who's winning and shit. Because, you know, that's what I do. I watch people winning. You know? And I said, you know, Dem Snore, he ain't losing yet. Right now the popularity going to him, so I should start heat with Dem Snore. I should lay this big, Nazi looking crazy man ass down for the count. That'll give something good on my resume, you know? So I'm starting to shoot heat to this big, retarded looking bastard. And all of a sudden, here come Ryan King with his mouth talking about how he gonna be the first. Like, what are you talking about, man? What are you talking about? This is heavyweight talk. This is big man talk. This is A-plus player talk. You are B-minus. You need to sit your ass down and sit your ass back to the kiddie table and shut the hell up with your gimmicks. You know? So, he started talking, he started throwing heat my way. I'm like, first of all, who the hell is this guy to be throwing heat my way? Then he started talking, bow down to the king. I said, hold up. I had to look at my phone a little bit closer. Yeah, I'm surprised I ain't had to get a pair of glasses with the foolishness. This dude was tweeting, talking about bow down to the king. This dude look like he need a big cup of milk. He look mildly nourished. You know what I'm saying? He talking that talk. I'm like, this guy's crazy. So, I start throwing the heat back at him. That's what you do in the business, man. Somebody throw heat, you throw heat back. But I didn't think this dude was actually serious. I thought actually it was a parody or something. Like he was part of the YouTube comedy channels and shit. That's what I thought. I didn't really think it was serious at first. But, you know, as time went on, we exchanged words and whatnot. It is what it is. You know, I thought that he was going to die down, to be honest with you. I wasn't taking it seriously. I talked the talk. But I ain't really taking it seriously because I'm like, yo, I can bench press this fool. If I put hands on this guy, yo, the SWF is going to have to call the cops. Because I'm going to make him into my personal slinky and whatnot. What up, man? Hey, girl, you got that look? Man, you better get out of here from that shit. We're getting back to what we were saying. Yeah, man, so he started throwing heat. He threw heat back and exchanged heat and whatnot. But I ain't taking it serious. I'm like, yo, this guy's crazy. I ain't taking it seriously. So, good a couple weeks, and I think it was a couple days, actually. A new federation came out in New York. New York must start a brand. The UFN Federation. Ultimate Fight Night Federation started laying their shit in. And I was like, okay. Because you know I keep my ear to the ground when it comes to the federations and shit in the gyms in New York. So I'm keeping my ear to the ground. They passed, they got in contact with me. Now, I ain't the type of dude to take the first offer. That, you know, you're a fighter, you've been in the fighting game for a while, you don't take the first offer. You just don't do that type of shit. That's some sucker shit. So I wanted to bubble. You know, I want to make that check bubble a little bit, you know? So I plan to wait here. Go on their site, I see this dude, Ryan King. I'm like, hold up. Now, I wasn't salty about the young man getting the position, but I'm like, come on, man. First of all, you stepped up to me, throwing heat my way, and then you gonna come and try to do a sucker move like that? What they do, pay you with McDonald's french fries and chicken nuggets? What the hell? Man, it cooked me up a little. So I said, you know, it's a perfect opportunity to put this silly bastard in his place. So, I got in contact with the UFN, and we got to negotiate. And you know what? I came out with a 3 million check, man. I'm sitting good, man. You know, Reese Demons, I just hired her. She's from the CWA, a part of their federation as well. Reese Demons, I just hired her. That's my manager right now. She's doing her thing. Shout out to you, girl. She's doing her thing. You know? But this guy, Ryan King, man, he's a joke, man. And I'm gonna bust his ass in the ring. I mean, SWF did me a favor. They put me in a cage with this fool. This is an easy win, man. I'm gonna bust that ass, man. All you people out there that like to make that money on the side, bet on your boy, man. Make some money, man. Put some money on, or put some dinner, some good dinner on your family table for your boy, Luke Luger, busting that ass on Ryan King. You know where to place that money. Place that money on your boy. You know? Ain't no way in hell this boy gonna beat me. Ain't no way in hell. Man, come on. Listen. Look at his matches and look at my matches. Look at his and look at mine. You could tell the different quality of the shit. You know what I'm saying? I had the match of the night. Though I lost, I had the match of the night. Why? Because fighters got in the ring. A fighter got in the ring with a fighter. A warrior got in the ring with a warrior. And we ripped the roof off. I'm not afraid to lose to a warrior. I lose to a warrior, it makes me look good. But we put on a good show, and we make that money. It's called filling them goddamn seats. Getting the SWF universe pumped up. Selling that merch. What Ryan King know about that? Ryan King selling plastic crayons to all the little girls and boys and shit. He trying to be the next John Cena. He ain't even, the boy don't even look like John Cena. He look like a pale version of one of those Ethiopian kids that you see in them commercials and shit. Crazy, man. Man, it's crazy out here, man. This boy let his last name get through his head, man. He let his last name get through his head. He think he the king. Man, blame your daddy, man, for this ass whooping, because your daddy should have never given you the name king. It got to your head. You know what I'm saying? It got to your head in a bad way, and I gotta put your ass in your place now. After this ass whooping, if he lived, if he could breathe, if the funny fool could talk right after I break his jaw two ways, you know, he might have to, he better just change his name, man. To Flying Ryan or some shit. You know, that's what I'm calling him. Crying, that's what I think I put that on the hashtag. That's what we're gonna call. His new name is Crying Ryan. Hashtag that, my people. Crying Ryan. You know? That's his new name. Crying Ass Ryan. Hashtag that. With his picture. And any match that he has, you hashtag Crying Ryan. That's what he do. He ain't no king. I ain't calling him no king. He clown. He gonna get his ass beat like a clown. A clown wearing a plastic crown. About to get his ass laid down. By your boy, Luke Luger, LL, the Outlaw. And that's facts right there. You know? And that's all I gotta say about this idiot. You know? That's all I gotta say. You know? Anything else that needs to be said, it's gonna be said in the ring with these two fists bouncing off his skull. You know? Daddy should never get in there. It's a damn shame. You're gonna be the downfall of that man. It's a damn shame. His daddy gonna be embarrassed, man. I'd be embarrassed. But I'm out of here, man. If anybody else wanna hold this interview with me, you know who to get to. Go to Reese Demons. I'ma leave her hashtag at the bottom. I'ma leave her. Y'all get at her on that interview. And she'll get in contact with me. And I expect that check in the mail. My interviews ain't cheap. But your boys out there, it was good talking to you.